We have all faced setbacks that felt like the end of the road. A moment when you questioned everything you had worked for and whether it was worth it. Or even felt cheated or betrayed after giving it your all. It's bound to happen to us all at some point. But what sets the successful people apart is their ability to rise above the setbacks and keep moving forward. It's not about avoiding failure, but how you respond to it. And as cliche as all that sounds, for Badou Jack, he has for sure faced his share of setbacks in the boxing ring. But with determination, perseverance, and years of hard work, Jack bounced back to defeat Alungo Mukabu for the WBC Cruiserweight World Championship to become a three-weight world champion. Now Jack is someone I've followed for a while, especially since he became the super middleweight champion versus Darrell back in 2015. And I've always been drawn to his come forward approach. And I'll be the first to admit though, he's never had the prettiest style in the eye. But I always thought fundamentally he was well rounded with a strong powerful jab, and very well timed right hands and solid inside game. While his tight high guard was able to block shots and help him catch and counter with some powerful punches. However, you can't deny it was his natural desire to always come forward and battle it out in the inside. And maybe in hindsight, this should have been something he looked to avoid at times, as it made fights a lot closer than they should have been. However, looking back at his pro career, I think we can take inspiration in terms of how he's managed to continually bounce back. You know, he was born and raised in Sweden, but represented in Gambia at the Olympics and lost in the first round, which was obviously a big disappointment. However, as he went into his pro career, he was on a roll at first, and it seemed like nothing could stop him. But in 2014, he suffered his first setback by getting knocked out, and it was a devastating loss for Jack, but he didn't let it defeat him. Instead, he used it as motivation to work harder and come back stronger, with that very next year becoming the super middleweight champion by defeating Darrell, before then going on to defeat George Groves in a tightly contested fight. He then went up against Lucien Boutte, where the fight was actually originally called a draw, with much initial disappointment. Only for it though to be turned around for a Jack win a year later, due to a failed drugs test from Boutte. However, this wouldn't stop Badou from taking the toughest challenge at the time, which of course was James DeGale, to unify the titles in what was a very entertaining fight, which I recommend you go back and watch, with both men going down and even the referee getting hit at one point. However, it would be called a majority draw, and once again, Jack was very unlucky not to have got the decision in this one, in my opinion. But Jack was a big super middleweight, and instead of trying to cut the weight, he would move up to light heavyweight and bounce back with a convincing display against Nathan Cleverley in the Mayweather-McGregor undercard and win his second weight division title. Jack again would then aim for the stars by going to Canada versus the big power-punching southpaw Adonis Stevenson, which was very much a fight of two halves if you ever watched it. And yes, once again, he suffered another draw in Montreal. I think at this point, anyone would start to become quite disillusioned with relying on the judges, but the show must go on. And the Swedish-born fighter would then go on to take another tough challenge in the former 2012 Olympian Marcus Brown, and suffered one of the worst cuts I think I've ever seen. The fight was also tough, and Badou Jack's gruesome cut on his forehead didn't let the injury slow him down at times, and instead he just dug deep and continued to fight. And by the end of the fight, both fighters and even the referee were just covered in Badou's blood, and it just looked like something out of a horror film, if I'm being honest. After taking some time to let the cut heal, he would later fight the end of the year versus Jean Pascal, and unfortunately, the bad luck was not over for Jack in this one, as he suffered an awful decision against him. Even looking at the CompuBox stats, it was reported Jack landed almost double of what Pascal had. After 3 years of some really disappointing decisions and bad injuries, most would give up at this point, especially with him not getting any younger. But Badou Jack kept coming back. And in boxing, a loss can often result in being treated as a journeyman. But for me, Jack proved that one, two, or even three losses didn't prevent him from bouncing back, and he did become a world champion again. Ironically, this issue of protecting one's undefeated record in boxing was probably brought to the mainstream by Floyd Mayweather, who had signed Jack. Yet, you saw Jack continuing to battle on, as moving forward is all we can really do to move on from the past. Instead, he took up the Kronk-based trainer Jonathan Banks and moved up to cruiserweight to aim for the stars one last time. Jack would then finally get his chance for another world title versus Makabu on the Jake Paul Tommy Fury card, and believe it or not as the main event. For me, it was clear since moving up to cruiserweight though, Banks was trying to get Jack to use more of his boxing ability. And for this fight against Makabu, who was a dangerous puncher in southpaw and was on a 6-year undefeated streak, he was certainly not going to be a pushover for Jack, who of course was the older fighter at 39. However, the work he put in this fight really impressed me, as he did look to use more of his footwork and set up his big right hand against the southpaw. I even liked at one point how he turned southpaw himself to keep Makabu guessing and even landing a few cheeky shots of his own. I guess some old dogs can learn some new tricks. As the fight went on, it was clearly close, and Badou Jack resorted back to his ripper mentality, taking the fight to Makabu.
But this is
big right hand, staggering Makabu. Jack swarming him. Badou Jack, look at me come. And Badou Jack has become a 3-division world champion. Badou Jack, the ripper.
Despite all the setbacks throughout his career, including the controversial losses and even a career-threatening injury, he never let those setbacks define him. Instead, he persevered and ultimately became a 3-weight world champion. And his story, to me, is a testament of the power of resilience and determination, and a reminder never to let setbacks beat you. So if you've ever lost or you're feeling defeated, just remember that setbacks are always temporary, but it's the determination to move forward and overcome them is what truly determines your character and how you keep moving forward. This has been Jamie from Boxing Life. I hope Badou Jack's story has maybe helped inspire some of you to keep pushing through. As always, guys, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.